I photodestirone. This one more green military electronics box. So do not mind the missing screws. I did already undo them in preparation for the video to save some time. And even I did already purchase replacement screws because the original one are not so good in condition and actually too short for the space they have. So I did take 1 centimeter long screw and they will fit perfectly. So what do we have here? It was on a classified website called on a military antenna tuner, but it is definitely something I did never see before for sale. So interesting. We have the manufacturer label here, made by in France by Alcatel-Thomson, called the AM341A or this type. Not sure about the manufacturing date code, but we have a NATO stock number here. And searching for this NATO stock number reveals it is called a parametric amplifier. Okay, made in France by Alcatel-Thomson. And actually, there was a Thomson CSF factory a few hundred meters from my childhood home. It was closed in the early 2000s, I believe, and became an industrial bakery, but the building itself is still here. They did just add extra stuff for the bakery part of it. But it was quite awesome to have a military electronics factory a few hundred meters from me. They were making mainly radio communication equipment. So maybe this box is coming from this factory. Could be really, really nice. So we have a big khaki box with one access panel here. We will check out, provided with anti-losing device here, and apparently provided with receptacle cap to install this panel here or here. Weird. Two covers on each side, big extra compartment here, which is part of the main unit. And on this side, just two connectors and one grounding point here, it seems. So one high frequency coaxial connector. And you can see they did provide provision to install this connector, this cap here, and same one for this multi-pin connector here. So it at most looked like the box was designed to be sometimes installed in a military vehicle or something, or sometimes removed and put in storage with a provision to secure, to protect your connectors. Really, really weird and interesting. Not usual, because when you install the box, you have usually you have plastic connector covers and you remove covers. You do not need them when the box is installed in the vehicle. And when you do maintenance, you reinstall your plastic covers. But this is not usual. So let's check this cover here. What is it all about? Not the correct size here, by the way. So maybe you will recognize this form factor and shape and size of what we could have behind this cover. Make your guess. Tadam! Yes, waveguide for radar, microwave, radio frequencies, or microwave communications, something. And I can totally install this cover here for storage, which I will do because I am not sure if I will need for the teardown to do this part or not. So let's get it ready. So interesting waveguide. So this box is somehow converting the coaxial input here to a waveguide, amplifying the signal. So do we have some kind of a magnetron inside or something? Probably microwave electronics. So should be quite fun and interesting to check out. We will see how far we can go in the disassembly. So let's remove first this cover on the multi-pin connector side. I'm really curious. What do you think we will have? So 19 screws on each cover, so really, really well put together. Yes, 19, really. 20, well, something like this. A lot of screws. What do you think we have in here? Ta-da! Cover. It is written power supply cover in France, capot Alim. In French, ok. Nice milling marks on this part, so it is milled from a bigger aluminium plate. So we have this. Yes, definitely some kind of power supply grade stuff. Not too impressive so far. Ah, we have a dead cord on the capacitor here. 1982, 1983, I can see on this one here. Okay. Texaco, so a French brand. You can see they were secured in place like this, but it is not totally a success for this one at least. Two regular fuse holders, they did mount like this. Some post-selection parts here, unidentified part here also with screw terminals, and this is connected here with plug ATT cannon like this, plastic connector shell here. Behind this we have a big green gray box. Shielded with a glass pass-through for the connections, I can see. My guess is a transformer. So this is mounted on standoffs with more Allen screws. I can see a wire passing through here. And probably one more connector here, it seems. Because two nuts and nine terminals like this. Okay, so interesting. I do not know if I will need to undo this board or not. Looks like we have stuff behind. So yes, probably I will need to undo it. But first, check on the other side. Which is probably the microwave components side, so we can expect nice stuff in here. Fingers crossed, at least. What do you think we will have? It is coming off. Ok. Colby Capo Hyper. For eyes hyper fréquence. Ok. Some kind of insulating material here. Same meaning tracks. So, here is what we have. I see gold. I see weird stuff. And probably super tedious things to remove. I am not sure how far I will be able to undo this thing. One more connector like this. Let's remove it to reveal a little bit more. So, we have a number of weird parts. Let's zoom. Your input plug is here with a nut. All those parts have numbers, model numbers, and serial numbers, it seems, on a label. This one is serial number 85. This one has a different part number, serial number 70. Okay, serial number 044 here. Interesting. So input is here. We are passing through two of those black boxes. I do not think I will be able to open them because the covers seem to be welded and also the screws are pretty well painted. It will be okay, not good. So we are passing through this unit here. You can see everything is bolted to the frame with Allen, but to remove individual modules, it will require to undo all these high frequency connections. Then it is passing through this box. So this, I believe, I will be able to open the cover. It is the connector here is in the way, but I can undo it, hopefully, and then reveal what we have in here. Also, I see behind these circuit boards we have a cover. So actually, I did already prepare this teardown and unsolder two wires here in the way to be able to undo this cover and reveal what we have under it. And then we are passing in this box here called Thomson CSF, this model. And if I this cover was glued in place, if I unglue it, we can see this. But same thing here, super tedious to take apart because the connectors on the side are screwed. So even if I can undo those screws here, it will not really help. Then we have output to the waveguide down here with this very special nut. I am not sure I will be even able to undo it. And we have the other side. Looks like a feedback, maybe side. So I am not sure if we have a power device in here. Really. Oh, there is an arrow here, so maybe this is the power device. Weird stuff. And you can see the weirdness continues here with this silver-coated bell-shaped part with solder over the nuts here. Really, really, really weird thing. And here, some kind of trimming adjustment done with little screws which were covered with red paint. And one more module here bolted to this one, but with some kind of an antenna side here. Really, really weird stuff. So let me just try one thing. Try to find a big flat wrench and try to poke this thing to see if it will unscrew. If it is locked in place, seems pretty locked, and I do not have a matching tool for this little. It will require a little special wrench in a half a circle with a pin. So I have some, but not that small. So I believe I will not be able to take this part very far apart. But here I will try to undo this connector and reveal what we have behind these two parts. First, let's undo the circuit board from the other side. For this, of course, I have to undo the connector here. So real quick. Okay, so spoiler, this rubber grommet is not original one, I did already replace it because the other one was bad. And here I should be able to undo now this circuit board and reveal what we have, but first I need to undo this screw terminals here. Not sure if it is some kind of circuit breaker protection device. Very, very short screws, by the way, as you can see. Are they magnetic or not? No. So probably brass. Not lose them because also, they seem to be imperial. Okay, so it should allow to undo this box later on and try to check. Oh, I can see it is written Teledyne on it. Quite nice. So let's undo the billion of Allen screws here securing this circuit board. Trying not to lose the washers, by the way. Super thin washers here. Well, you can see the whole box seems to have been machined from an aluminium block. Quite impressive. Okay, it should allow to undo the board if I am not annoyed with whatever we have here at this level. Okay, ah oui, non, one more screw. Hop, it is good now. No. Wow. Really, really seriously made this stuff. Even if its board is not that beautiful. Is it coming off? Yes, okay, it does reveal a one band of power resistance. So is it some kind of a dummy loader? Okay, board is out. You can see. Rear side of a PCB, really not impressive. Rough condition, even for this connector here, burn mark here around this power transistor. So not the best condition, definitely. This thing was used, obviously. So behind the board we have six power resistors. So you're trying to see they are all connected in two groups of three parallel. It looks like, yes, 220 ohms. This furnace brand, of course. We have two extra parts here. I believe those are precision resistors, something like this. Here it is written VE3101. Okay, not a usual package, by the way. Your connector to the other side, the wire harness on the other side. And we need to check this Teledyne thing, if there is anything else written on it. Because also I did never see something like this before. Is it okay? Clean screwdriver. Long screw here. And okay. Teledyne relays, solid state relay, control and load. Okay. 3.8 to 32 volts DC control and load of 10 volts to 10 amps, 220 volts AC. From 37 to 440 hertz. So could be used in an aircraft also. Teledyne relay, part number 602-1. I was not expecting this. I will put it back in place. So really a nice part already. It looks like it is empty or no, it is just the... It is hollow, but no, it is just the holes for the screws. Okay, so nice find here, at least. Not the expected stuff you see usually. Okay, so here we have a gray box secured by screws the other side, but with the wires and everything, it will not be easy to access it. So I will leave it in place. It is just a metal box, anyways, completely soldered together. Okay, so for this side we are good for now. I will not restart the circuit board immediately because we have to check what we have the other side. So here are two things I can do. First, undo this connector. We will check real quick what we have behind this small printed circuit. So the other one here is the same. So I will do only one of them. Let me grab the matching tool to undo, of course, not the correct one, to undo those four little Allen's. Really, really small stuff here. Okay, nice. The parts are falling everywhere. Let me flip this thing over to try to retrieve them. Ah, I love this. lose spacers. The worst thing you can have, really. So what do we have? Okay. I am missing a spacer somewhere. I believe I will need to fix it out. So here we have a little extra cover behind this cover. Let me change one more time my screwdriver head, and I am even centered in video. Yes, okay. Undo those four tiny screws. Oops. Really annoying. Missing washer here. I have one here, okay. I did already check actually what we have here. And spoiler, it is a lot of work, but guess what? Guess what? So silver coated plate. All this for that. We see three holes with some golden material inside. You can see it is welded all around. So maybe they are welded covers. Or some weird RF voodoo happening here, but I do not see even this connector where it ends at this side. Really weird. Two or four even little pass-through here, you can see, with diodes on them. But nothing more to see. This circuit board has three transistors, a few resistors connected to this thing. So if you have any idea of what it could be, I do not see any obvious power device in here. So if it is an amplifier, you must have a power device. It might be this one, but this one will not be possible to remove because it would involve undoing everything else, and this is not here, is completely stuck, and do not have a correct tool. I do not want to do too much damage to this thing. Okay, I will reinstall this part and we will check out this cover here. Okay, thanks to the magic of video editing, I will just need later to resolder these two wires here, not a big deal. So here, the connector is in the way, so I need to undo it. But guess what? My socket here will not fit, I need to get a flat wrench. Okay. Okay, Facom, flat wrench, what else? Do I have a matching screwdriver? Yes. Quite a bit sad to be forced to undo this connector, but if I want to access, there is one screw just at the bottom and totally covered by the connector. I hope it will be of any interest. Okay, it will come right off with extra loose parts, of course. I need to fish them out, but I will do it later. Let me reinstall the camera and zoom as much as possible while I find the correct screwdriver to undo this cover. So there is some kind of an adjustment here, it seems. Wow, super tiny stuff. So sadly the other parts will not be possible to take apart because they are covered with paint. Oh, super mega tedious. This golden thing here is really, really interesting, but and they are all welded and glued together, it seems, and will not reveal a lot. It would be completely destructive to try to do anything else. And guess what? We have a stripped Allen. I will be right back. So I did just hammer in place a Torx bit. Okay. And okay, so as you can see in the cover we have some kind of an adjustable piece. You will turn and it will go up or down and it will somehow do some kind of coupling with this part here on this ceramic plate with RF Voodoo tracks here. Really weird stuff. It will not reveal a lot more, sadly. But I am trying to see if I can arrange it as a nice video thumbnail, maybe like this. Yes, seems quite nice, but this connector is in the way. Okay. Total view of a thing for you. Well, really, really weird stuff. Sadly, it is not possible to really to take apart the other things. It will be completely destructive, I guess. But it is what it is. At least we are granted with one beautiful sight of things we do not know what they are. Okay. So I guess it will be all for this box. I have some reassembly hidden, obviously. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.